And we're back. Hello, everybody. This is What Do You Want From Me with It's Your Girl Bella and
Liv.
What the hell was that intro? That was terrible. Liv is just coming off of a whole, like, I don't even know, like, we'll talk about it later. We're going to go into it later because she's just, her common sense is so out the window. This was such a weird intro, but we got this. All right, let's restart this. Ready? What do you want from me? Hey, guys, it's your girl, Bella.
And Liv!
That's your girl, Liv.
I thought I was saying my name.
And this is What Do You Want From Me? Two dysfunctional people together in the basement of Iona College.
We have no life.
Thanks. They didn't need to know that.
Sorry.
Welcome to the show. So we actually wanted to start off the show with a little story time, a little adventure time with us. So we met an interesting character when we went into the city.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, oh my God, we made a decision to go drive into the city at like 10 something at night on a Wednesday. It was a random Wednesday. And we decided to go into the city and get crepes. Now, we didn't think it would be popping. Like, we didn't think it would be packed. We thought we were just going to drive up, get crepes, whatever. There was a long line. Everybody was outside.
Everybody and their mom was outside.
We outside. Oh, my God. Where we at? We outside. Everybody was outside.
Literally.
We get there, right? And there's this dude. And the first interaction we have with this dude is he's looking at the floor and there's a heart drawn on the street. And he goes,
I think he did it himself, though.
He did it. He goes, I lost my heart. Who would I give my heart to? Oh, it's right there. It's right there. So this dude was obviously on some type of drugs. Like, this dude was...
And drunk. I think
he was drunk.
He had a bottle had of... A tall boy of something. It was a cacti.
It was a cacti drink.
The drink that's disgusting.
Cacti is not good.
Literally gross. I haven't tried it, and I don't want
to. Okay, well, actually,
I
don't mind it because I'm a tequila girl. So, like, to me, like, this weird mixed drink.
But you literally have...
I have two cases that
sitting in your car doing nothing. I step on them every time I get in your car. So
no, I used them the other day to play like beer pong and drinking games because I needed to get them out. Like I just needed them to go.
Yeah, no.
Because they're not a fan favorite. They're not my favorite, but they're doable for me. Everybody else I try to get drink them, they hate them.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so he was drinking this disgusting cacti Travis Scott drink, and basically what happened was he thought he lost his heart. Like, he gave his heart to somebody. He couldn't find it. The heart was on the street. He drew the heart. Mm-hmm. So he's walking around. Who stole my heart? Who stole my heart? Now, okay. New York City crackhead's normal, right? All of a sudden, all my friends made this mistake. I didn't. My feet were covered.
My feet were covered, too. I think I had Crocs on.
You had Crocs on.
I had Crocs on.
It was our other two friends who decided to show their feet in the city.
Yep.
And this dude happened to have a foot fetish.
Mm-hmm.
Now, not a normal, like... thing, because you know, whatever, you could have a fetish and just not talk to anybody about it, like keep it to yourself,
right?
You
like
and your
private.
Girl, whatever, you want to suck your girl's toes, do whatever. This dude decided to go on a rampage.
Oh my god,
you
didn't leave her alone.
Go, you tell it.
So basically, like, I was standing with Bella, the other girls were Corinne and Sid, and Corinne was the girl's toes that he was obsessed with, and he goes up there and he goes, oh my God, like I don't remember what exactly
he was
said,
like, oh my God,
like,
I love your feet. Oh my God, I love your feet. Like, yo, I got a thing for feet.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a real man. I got a thing for feet. Like, yo, my ex-girl, she used to be like a foot girl.
Yep.
What's up?
We were trying to look away from him, like, okay,
we're
he's just going
to,
off
like,
at a table.
Yeah,
like, I don't want to listen to this
like,
anymore.
Like, when people are like that, you usually just turn away. What's a foot girl? Now, all of a sudden, I don't know how, he got our attention. And I was freaking out because I didn't have a mask.
Didn't. You so had like your sweatshirt over or whatever.
We had like this random like dude on the street coming up to us. Where he's from. All we know is he lifeguarded at Coney Island.
Right, exactly. He said that. He showed
us
pictures.
He said, you want to see how tan I get? You want to see how tan I get? And
oh my God. And he didn't have a mask on. So that's part of the reason why
we
were like,
I was like, bro, I'm not even like freaked out about that stuff. But at the same time, New York City was so packed. It freaked me out.
Yeah, no. Corinne was like intrigued. Not Corinne. Corinne wasn't like intrigued.
But
like
she was
like interested.
She was like, you know, you're not the first guy to tell me about my feet. And I'm like, what is this conversation? So then it keeps going, and he's showing us.
Eventually, he shows us he's like a different Instagram that
So he's apparently a photographer, right?
Yeah.
So he takes normal pictures, and then he takes feet pictures, and then he's showing us these feet people on Instagram, these feet girls. Mm-hmm. And he's like, yo, look at them. Girls. 500K followers, 275K followers. I'm like,
and he's just scrolling through his phone.
God. He showed us one of this girl playing with her toes in the camera. And I was like, oh my God.
This is
like,
literally so cringe.
I was like, this is so like, it just like freaked me out. It reminded me of like galactic, like ET like stuff. I almost cursed. And like these toes are playing in the main camera, and I'm like, oh my
god, toes are playing in the main camera. Like, she's like moving her toes. I don't know, it's weird.
They're like, like alien fingers. And then I was like, I'm freaked out. He goes, yo, I'm turned on. Then he goes, this is what got me. He goes, yo, let me pimp your feet out. What do you mean, pimp her feet out? He goes, yo, let me pimp your feet out. You know how many people would pay $50?
Mm-hmm. He wanted to make an Instagram for her feet.
Make an Instagram for her feet. He was like, yo, no. My ex-girl used to do this. She used to fly out to Chicago, all these places. And then she would, like, book hotel rooms and go around and, like, let people play with her feet. Her feet
for money. Like, that's, yeah. Like
so
that's crazy.
So I'm, like, sitting there, and I'm like, oh, my God, this dude. He's showing us all the stuff. He's like, yo, I'm turned down right now. Then Corinne wanted him to leave us alone. So he goes, please, please, let me see the bottom of your feet. Let me see the bottom. He's like, $50. How much can I, what can I do for $50? Like, let me show your feet some love. Like, let me give your feet some love, $50, like, whatever. She goes, okay, like, whatever. She's showing, hi. So she's showing her, oh my God, is she going to walk in here? I hope not. Okay. So there's a girl outside. So she walks in, like, she literally lifts her foot out of her slide. And she's showing the dude the bottom of her feet so we can, like, have, like, whatever. We could go on our merry way because he was walking up and down, and he was like, oh, my God. Like, what are you looking at?
She walked in here, but I think she's going to walk out.
Okay. Oh, there's, like, a girl.
I feel bad.
Yeah. Okay. Anyways, so this person, like, is, like, trying to grab the bottom of her feet. And she's like, hell no, you can look, but you can't touch. Right. Like, what you mean? Mm-hmm. And she's like, nah, I don't want my feet pimped out. This dude's talking about how he's a real man. He likes feet, whatever. Like, he's turned on right now. And then he's telling everybody, like, on the street about Corinne's feet. Like,
he won't stop talking about it.
Well, so then we get our crepes and we, like, literally.
We had to wait so long.
We waited so long for them. And we had to literally, we dipped and whatever. Yeah. But, like, oh, foot fetish. Like, I just never understood those.
I think they're gross. Like, I honestly like will never understand how someone could be so obsessed with feet to the point that it turns them on or that it's like attractive.
That it's attractive, like, that you're following somebody who's just like playing with their feet in a camera, and to you this is like gets you going.
Yeah, like it's like entertaining. Not even entertaining, like more than that, but like I just like arousing. It's it's disgusting.
Oh my God, he said, gross. Let me make love to your feet. What does
I
that
think
mean?
That is disgusting.
Ugh, it was so disgusting.
I think it's gross. I don't know.
But he was literally making me laugh. And if it wasn't COVID, I would have been like, whatever, he's talking to us, whatever. Then he daps Corinne up and leaves because he saw the bottom of the foot. He got what he needed.
Oh, and he kept saying, yo, I'm gonna tell you guys this one last thing, and then I'm gonna leave you guys alone. He said that 10 times.
He's like, yo, one more thing, and I'll leave you alone.
Liar.
Yo, this is me at Coney Island. One more thing, and I'll leave you alone.
Right. Like, oh my God. Like, okay.
Yeah, no, I don't have any weird fetishes at all. I'm not into any of that stuff.
Neither am I.
No, I don't have, like, any fetishes. There's nothing that, no, not at all. I just like when guys are mean to me. But not, like, mean.
I will never understand that.
Not, okay, but, like, it's not mean. It's just, like,
like, flirtatious mean, right? Or, like,
yeah,
you mean,
like, you could just
like,
be,
you're
like,
trying to act tough. But, like, it's a flirtatious way. So, you're not being mean. You're being...
Yeah, like, you're calling me ugly, but really, you think I'm pretty. Like, I know you think I'm pretty, but you're calling me ugly. So, now, my ego is, like, I'm, like, now I'm riled up. Because now I'm, like, oh, I'm ugly. I'm ugly. So, then I'm going back. Like, what you're saying, like, fight me.
You bruise your ego.
My ego's always bruised.
Yeah, so, act out.
What?
You act out when your ego's bruised. You're, like, oh, I'll come back 10 times better.
Facts, I do. Every time, like, one little thing.
I mean, I don't think your ego's actually bruised, but...
I don't know. I kind of, like, low-key have a big ego, but, like, it's not, like, a bad ego. It's just, like, you know, how I feel about myself. And then when someone, like, ruins it, then I get upset. But then I'm like, wah! Like,
pop out.
But, like, pop if off. You're bruising it in a funny way that, like, you know, it's flirtatious or whatever, and we're chilling, yeah. like, we're chilling, it's cool. Mm. But, like, or saying, like, fight me. Like,
fight me, fight me.
Yeah, like, fight me. Like, yeah, I'll fight you. Yeah, I'll fight you. Like, my 5'2", like, 130 pounds. Yeah, like, I got it. I got it. Like, you ain't that tall. You skinny, scrawny. I, like, insult men. And then I think that's why I don't have a boyfriend.
That's true, because to a point, they flirting. Don't like when you're too tough. They don't like that. They not that I'm saying you gotta be soft. I'm not saying you have to be soft. I'm just saying, to a point, they don't want you to be like their boy. Like, you're acting tough to them, they're like, oh, that's my boy. Like, that's like,
I know,
like, I don't,
I've done better, I've done better, I've done better, I've been a little more girly,
a little more mushy and nice. Oh, that's gross.
Don't do that. Oh my gosh. Okay, so we're gonna be right back after the break, and then Liv's gonna tell us what weird thing she's into, because there has to be something. See you later. I'm swimming in the mirror. Pokemon, wiggling the vision. Heat waves, I'm swimming in the mirror. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. Heat waves been freaking me out. Can't make you happier now. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. Heat waves been freaking me out. Can't make you happier now. Usually I put something on TV, so we never think about you and me. But today I see our reflections clearly in Hollywood, laying on the screen. You just need a better life than this. You need something I can never give. Fake water all across the road. It's gone, now the night is come. But sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. Heat waves been faking me out. Can't make you happier now. You can't fight it, you can't breathe. You say something so loving, but now I gotta let you go. You'll be better off in someone new. I don't wanna be alone. You know it hurts me too. So broken when you cry. One more and then I say goodbye. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. He waves been faking me out. Can't make you happier now. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. He waves been faking me out. Can't make you happier now. I just wonder what you're dreaming of when you sleep and smile so comfortable. I just wish that I could give you that look that's perfectly unsaid. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. He always been faking me out. He always been faking me out. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. Heat waves been faking me out. Can't make you happier now. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. Heat waves been faking me out. Can't make you happier now. Hey guys, we are back.
Yo,
Olivia, the floor is yours.
Okay, so weird things. I don't really know if you'd call it a weird thing, but something that I like is being challenged, like the challenge of getting someone. Like, if okay. I like talk to you and you're like, all up in my face, like thirsty. You're like, oh, I'm trying to date you. I want to be your boyfriend. Like that, like, kind of turns me off. Like, I feel like just as much as I want to play hard to get, like, they got to play hard to get too, which I feel like that's a girl thing. But like, I like a challenge.
No, she likes a challenge. I don't know what it is. Attitude. I don't know what it is, but like, the more drama for Liv, I feel like she, in the moment she doesn't like it, but then like, it just feeds the relationship. It's like,
yeah, I don't even like the drama.
It's, you don't like it, but you stick with it. So like, I feel like
clearly it doesn't bother me that
clearly,
much.
Clearly, no, clearly here. You like it. Like, clearly. No.
Maybe subconsciously.
The screaming voice notes.
I like it.
Okay, so we wanted to talk about, so we're very thankful for the few people that have listened to our stuff. I'm gonna start posting our stuff on social media so more people can listen. So this episode will be the first.
Oh god.
That I'm gonna put the link. I'm gonna put the link in my bio for everybody to listen. But we've had a good amount of people listen. I've had people in my tanning salon actually tell me.
Really?
Like, they've heard the clips on my Instagram story.
On the reels.
And they were like, you have such an, like, you have such iconic voices.
Mm, like, I've been trying to show my mom, but she haven't had time.
Sorry. Yeah, that's why you just send the link, and eventually when they listen to it, they listen to it, you know? Right. So my grandma said, so one of our fans, my grandma, she listens to every show twice. She loves it. Her little, like,
product. Twice? Yeah. She told you that?
Oh my god, I listened to it twice. That's so amazing. Yeah, she loved it. My uncle Michael listened.
Oh my god, okay.
He liked that we talked about him for 2 seconds. We're gonna definitely talk about him more because he's such a story.
He's an icon.
He's an icon. and Professor Mandelbaum, our main supporter, out here telling the class how good we are. I'm so thankful. Thank you. He had a comparison for us that once I said it to other people, they agreed. And I was like, oh. So we had to dig deeper, and I assigned a "What do you want for me?" homework assignment, and I said, "I said let's watch Paris Hilton and Nicole Richie because apparently we are two hot messes, and it reminds my teacher of this show, A Simple Life with Paris Hilton and Nicole Richie. This show is hysterical.
It was watched like a 10-minute." Yeah, funny moment thing, but just from that.
Oh my god, yeah, I think I watched like 20 minutes of like funniest moments from that show because I don't know where to find the full episodes because this is before.
Yeah, where is this? Is like, looks like 2005.
Low key before our time because in 2005 we were
like
five, six years old, depending on how early our birthdays were.
Yeah.
So this was way before our time, but they are hysterical, and I actually see the similarities between us.
I see a low key similarity. I don't know.
So Liv was texting me and she was like, oh, we have way more common sense than them. You should hear what, like,
you should hear what we say.
You should hear when Liv and I just speak and then we're like, oh, that should have happened. Or
like, we're too, like, dumb. Like, we're dumb and dumber. Like, I swear to God, we are.
I don't remember how, like, we used to get so told that a lot. I don't know who said that.
Maybe Sid? No, I don't know.
Someone called us dumb and dumber before. I think my uncle did. I think Uncle Mike did. But literally dumb and dumber. We've been called that a few times. Yeah. And I kind of understand it.
I 100% understand it. Like, if I don't get something, you're like, wait, is that the way it's supposed to be? I'm like, yeah, no, I don't think so. And then we're like, both, yes, it is. And I'm like,
not even that. And then we're both wrong. And we're sitting there and we're like, huh?
You were like confused. Like, what?
Liv has this noise that she makes. And she's like, huh? But
I wish I had like an example. I really wish
I really wish example. I could think about like
there's
all
just
the
been times, too many times
where think, we've honestly. Gone out or we've done something stupid or we've just like been stupid together, and there's just so many moments that it's just
the common sense was just not there.
Not there, out the window, and it's not there for Nicole Richie and Paris Hilton because stupid. In the show basically to sum it up, they are sent to certain parts of America to live a simple life. Basically, they are not,
they don't live a simple life.
No, because they're spoiled kids who are raised with money. So me and Liv are far from that. We actually are in the simple life.
Yeah,
we just never gained the common sense from a simple life, apparently. So, who's who? I think you're Nicole Richie.
I feel like I'm Nicole. Because what she did, I mean, I don't know. Honestly, I feel like I'm a little bit of both. I could be a little bit of both. I got to watch a little more. No, but from
Nicole,
what I got.
If one of us had to be who, you would be Nicole.
Doobie Paris.
Oh my god, so Nicole Richie in one scene was they worked at a crematory, a funeral home or whatever,
home, yeah.
And they had to put the ashes in a and an urn, a yearn.
It's called an urn. Yep. Mm-hmm.
And so she goes, so they're like, oh my God, this is disgusting. There's people floating
and they were
on
using,
me.
They were using like a funnel to get it into the, because they didn't want to spill
it. And then Nicole Richie goes, I'm going to write them a goodbye note. And she goes to write the goodbye note and she knocks somebody's ashes
on the
floor.
She knocked them on the floor. And she was like, Paris!
Paris! And Liv texted me and she goes, that's me.
I'd be so distracted that I would just knock it on the floor. And then they vacuumed it. They vacuumed it up after, like, I don't think that's what you're supposed to do.
You're supposed to put the ashes back because it's a person.
Yeah, that's literally someone's, like, remains, but okay.
So basically, that's Nicole, and I'm definitely Paris. There were certain Paris moments where she was just, like, I don't like to do gross things, and, like, I do not like to get my hands dirty at all, and Liv is kind of better at that than me. Like, I literally don't even like to wash dishes. Yeah. I wash dishes, but, like, the fact that there's food on the plate.
Like, it'll gross you out enough to point.
So,
like,
there were certain moments where Paris was working at Sonic.
Oh, yeah.
And just, like, all this stuff is so funny, and then there's this one scene where she was, like, getting arrested before she got arrested, and she's, like, looking in the rearview mirror, and she goes, every time I see a mirror, I have to look at myself. And I do that every time I walk past a car. I look in the window to see my reflection.
Yeah.
Anytime I walk against a glass thing, I want to see I want to see what my body looks like. I don't know. I just like to look at myself.
Yeah, same. And I think
my mom called me out on that one. She's like, you're always looking at yourself. I'm like, okay.
Yeah, no, my dad's friend, because I used to go to a beach club and I had a mirror in there, like a full-size mirror. And I'm not even kidding. I would stop in there probably 10 times a day to look at myself. And he'd be like, so do you enjoy looking at yourself? Like, what are you doing? And I'd be like, I just stand here and look at myself. I know.
I walk past a mirror. I'm not going to not look
14.
In it. And I didn't know that was a Paris Hilton quote before it was a Bella quote. So, like, now that I know,
you know,
I'm basically her predecessor.
Yeah.
Except I wasn't born into the Hilton Hotel money.
Oh, no.
Not at all.
I don't know if you saw, but there was another scene where they were getting out, and I think they were staying in these guys. Like, I don't know if they were in college. I'm not sure. And she was looking at him, and she was like, oh, you know when a guy looks like put together like that. Like, this wasn't exactly word for word, but she was basically saying like that, like, when a guy looks like really put together, like, you don't want to be nice to them. Like, I didn't understand it.
I think
but
she
I was
said,
like,
so, she
like
said
I
something
that.
Like, well, I get that.
Yeah.
Because if you look too nice, you
then,
look
like,
too...
you're not nice. Like, why should I be nice to you? I mean, I think that's what she was saying.
And maybe that's what she meant. But for me, if, like, somebody is just, like, way too put together,
way too
I'm
put
like,
together,
then,
yeah, like, stay away.
Like, give me some, like, I don't know. Give me some, like, story.
Yeah.
Like, I need to
like,
look at
you. You shouldn't look like that.
You shouldn't look like you have everything figured out.
Something
right.
needs
something
to
be wrong.
Wrong with you. You have to have
something.
Some sort of flaw.
You can't wear these khaki and vineyard vines and be on the golf course and then whatever, because it's not
I wish
work.
I remember what exactly she said, but I think we have the right idea.
Yeah, so basically now the thing is we're gonna do a little like friendly roast session to end the show, and we're basically gonna go back and forth. It's I didn't even plan this, so I have no idea what I'm gonna say, and Liv doesn't know it either. It says it in the show right
oh,
now.
I think I already know what you're gonna freaking roast.
Why are each other hot messes? So Liv's gonna go first because I can't think of one. What makes me a hot mess?
You're a hot mess because there's something in my head that
this is an identifiable factor of our show. We need to understand. This is psychology 101, I think, or something like that.
Yeah.
We need to I don't know if it is. We
no.
need to
I don't know.
We need to understand why we're hot messes.
Maybe you're a hot mess because you go for fraternity boys who do not care. You catch feelings. You catch mad feels. Like, they're going to hang out with you and all they want to do is drink, party, smoke, do whatever they want to do. And then you're over here, oh, I'm so butthurt. Oh, should I talk to him? No, you shouldn't talk to him.
That's
you're
not
giving the time of day.
That's just roasting. That's not hot mess. If you want to go that route, Miss Olivia.
No, you can roast me. I
trauma. She loves the drama, the trauma, everything. It's like, you know what? You want to be a big man, baby? I love you.
I love you. I'll deal with it anyway.
I'll do anything for you. Cry, baby.
No,
cry.
There was something else that I wanted to say, and I couldn't think
of
it. I didn't want to waste time.
You're a hot mess because of your dance moves.
My dance moves.
When we're out and about, the way you dance when we're out and about.
Oh, I know. The way I dance. Oh, my God.
It literally reminds you of, like, Dumb and Dumber. Like, if you see just Liv dancing, she's, like,
so
goofy.
I
mad
dance
goofy.
Really stupid. Mad I mean, goofy. I dance, though. Like,
but that's
I,
what I mean by hot mess. Like, being fun. You don't have to roast our dating lives. Oh.
Okay.
I don't have a dating life.
Well, you said a roasting session, so you know
it is a roast.
You put it out for interpretation. I could have really said anything I wanted.
Yeah, no, you're right.
Oh my god, I'm so mad right now.
Why? You can't think of it?
There's something in my head.
I don't know. I'm a spaz. I fall a lot. I'm clumsy. I don't know what I drink.
There was something you did the other day.
What I did?
Oh my god. When we're driving, she is horrible at judging how much space she has. She literally, you could fit a Mack truck in between where she's trying to go. She's going, oh my god, I don't think I can fit. And I'm like, are you serious right now? Like, she can't, or she parks mad far away from the curb.
She parks on a slant. No, if you want to call me a hot mess,
but then
for
she calls me a grandma driver.
Drive.
So.
Because you're so
grandma.
Soft.
No,
I like
you drive
to
too
think,
fast. You drive up people's butts.
Because you know what? Get on my type of time.
No, but not everybody wants to be on your type of time.
I'm Vin Diesel in woman form.
Well, not everybody wants to drive like that. Some people
like,
are just
get
relaxing.
Out the way. I beep at people when they drive too slow. I'm that person. I don't care. Why are you driving so slow? And you're not even old. If you're not under 50 and you're driving. If you're not. What do you say?
I said you're that curse word. There's a curse word in my head, but I can't say it.
Oh my god, no. My road rage is so bad. If you want to hear a hot mess story, okay, I'm going to say it on this. And then I'm going to regret it instantly. So there's this one road rage story.
I don't know if you ever told me about this.
I was on my way to my house because my family.
Why is your voice so high now?
Because now I'm nervous because I was on my way.
You don't have to tell it if you want
to. No! Transparency, we need to turn it up a notch. I was on my way to my house, right?
Mm-hmm.
Driving on the hutch.
Mm-hmm.
My windows were down. It was a nice day.
Mm-hmm.
I was driving back from
here. Let's go.
So I'm in traffic, right? And this person was driving like an asshole and he kept trying to come off.
Excuse me.
Oh my god, Ayana, I'm sorry. He was driving like a jerk and he's trying to cut me off. So backstory, I really had to pee. I was honestly in bumper to bumper traffic. I did not need anyone trying to cut me off because I was almost at the gas station to pee.
Mm-hmm.
And I was going to pee myself.
Okay.
This guy almost hits me and tries to cut me off. And then he cuts it to the lane that I need to get into to get to the mobile. So I couldn't get to the mobile. So now I had to hold my pee in all the way home because there's no other bathroom. So literally my window was down and I was so mad and I literally screamed, I'm gonna pee on your mom. And this dude looks at me, he goes, you have issues. And I'm like, well,
wait, you shouted that and
he heard me because we're bumper to bumper. He didn't get very far.
Oh my god.
I was like, I said a few curse words and then I said, I'm gonna pee on your mom. And he goes, what do you mean you're gonna pee on my mom? And he's like, you have issues, like literal issues. And I was like, you know what? And I flipped the bird, and then I rolled out my window no one else would hear me. And I just went on my
merry
way.
You really never told me about
that. And then
that.
I went home, and I told my whole family, my aunts, everybody was there. And I'm like, I just told somebody I was going to pee on their mom. And they're like, why are you proud of this?
Yeah, like, why are you, like, going around saying, oh, look what I did.
I'm going to pee on your mom. I was so mad. I was so mad. And I would never pee on somebody's mother. Just don't put it out there. I barely pee in, like, outside. Like, you know, when people could squat and pee, I don't like that.
Yeah, I don't like when people do that either. I highly agree with that because...
Yeah, I could never.
I think that's really, really unladylike and gross. Don't do that.
Yeah, I mean...
Word of advice, don't do that.
I don't have a ladylike mouth, but...
Yeah, neither do I. Honestly, this show is really...
Really showing some truth. Because we have trucker
mouth. It's testing
me. Because Liv is literally like...
I have the
worst
mouth.
One of the hot mess things that Liv does is she's like... Yo, like one.
I throw F bombs around. Like,
one day she's Olivia Mary Conti, the next day she's like,
it depends on
Oliver.
The day,
she's like,
yeah,
Oliver Mark Conti, and she's like, yo.
Like I could be really, really nasty.
What I mean by that is sometimes she gets this really deep voice all of a sudden, and then it's just like,
yeah, I know.
Whoa, it's like, dude.
I think it's the Gemini.
The Gemini. There's a man and a
in me.
Girl in her.
Ew. I don't want that.
Oh my gosh. Well, that was it. If we come up with more stuff, we're definitely gonna exploit each other because that's the whole point of this is to get you guys laughing and get us, you know, out there. But right now, that's all we have for today. Liv, say bye to everybody.
Bye, everyone.
We'll see you next time. What do you want from me? With Belle.
And Liv.
And I ain't never had this happen before, man.